my singular honor and privilege to present a check of 1 million naira each to the 82 beneficiaries who shall be provided with accommodation by the government of Borno State, the medical doctors, to the glory of God and to the benefit of humanity.
This is indeed a promise made, promise kept for the Borno State Governor, Professor Babagana Umar Azalam, as he ushered in the month of July with the allocation of the doctor's quotas and presentation of 1 million naira check as furniture allowances to each of the 81 medical doctors' allottees. This is in fulfillment of his administration promise to improve working condition of the doctors and enhance better healthcare delivery service. Governor Babagana Umara also directed that bus should be stationed at the quarters for transporting them to hospitals for healthcare services.
I know most of you have sacrificed by agreeing to receive an amount less than what is being paid at the federal institutions. Until recently, we harmonized the salary structure between that of the federal government and that of the states. And I want to assure you that Governor Borno State will continue to support our doctors that are working with the state government. For those of you that are willing to further your career, inshallah, we shall provide an enabling environment for you to proceed.
Your Excellency, sir, the tremendous support and opportunities you have given to doctors that are serving in the state is appreciated by all. And believe you, sir, we are going to reciprocate by ensuring that we provide the appropriate services that is required by our people, by God's grace, inshallah. We will not let you down. We have seen your effort, and inshallah, we will make sure we put on our best to serve humanity.
Also in the month of July, Governor Zulum commissioned a 30-bed capacity primary health center, fully equipped with state-of-the-art facilities constructed by his administration in Wulari area of the state capital. Similarly, Professor Babagana Umara launched the free maternal drugs worth 300 million naira to be distributed to healthcare centers within the Maiduguri metropolis. He urged the Ministry of Health and Human Services to sustain the Wulari Health Center and assured of continuous provision of effective and affordable health services in the state.
We are here to witness the commissioning ceremony of this very vital project. This administration within the last 3 years have constructed and rehabilitated close to 100 health facilities in Borno State. Not only the provision of the infrastructure that we did, we have also provided equipment and other medical infrastructures that are needed to support the healthcare delivery systems in the state. We have provided doctors and other health workers to almost all the health facilities in Borno State.
Governor Zulum also in the month of July commissioned a 2.17 kilometer remote polytechnic Wulari linked road and drainage network connecting the area to other parts of the metropolitan.
It is my singular honor and privilege to commission this very vital road from the Maiduguri Kano main road beside Ramat Polytechnic Maiduguri to Wulari to the glory of God and to the benefit of humanity.
In line with his administration recovery drive, Professor Babagana Umara has inaugurated a committee on the return and repatriation of Borno indigents and management of repentant insurgents. Governor Zulum inaugurated a 26-member committee at the Council Chamber Government House, which is headed by the Deputy Governor Umar Usman Kadafur, to fast-track the repatriation of over 200,000 refugees, mostly from Borno State, who fled to neighboring Niger, Cameroon and Chad republics about 8 years ago following attacks by Boko Haram. Also inaugurated by Professor Babagana Umara was the committee to facilitate the safe and dignified resettlement of displaced persons of Gudumbali and Merari towns of Guzamala local government. The 24-member committee is chaired by the Commissioner for Local Government and Emirate Affairs, Sugun Maimele, and the Commissioner for Reconstruction, Rehabilitation and Resettlement, Engineer Mustafa Gubiu, as co-chairman. Addressing the two committees, Governor Umar Azlam said, the National Working Committee inaugurated by President Muhammadu Buhari early this year under the chairmanship of the Vice President will soon visit the state and will work with them to ensure speedy and successful return of the people of concern.
If the issue of repatriation and management of the returnees of the insurgents is properly handled, I strongly believe that we shall witness additional mass surrender of members of the sect, willing to put down their arms, knowing fully if there is no peace, there will be no any meaningful development. The magnitude of this assignment suggests the membership of the committee under the distinguished chairmanship of His Excellency Honorable Umar Usman Kadafur, the Deputy Governor of Borno State, and other top government functionaries who, I'm confident, will justify the confidence we have in them. Furthermore, I must confess that the assignment is going to be tedious, but I'm confident in the ability and the capability of the caliber of well-experienced people in the committee. Therefore, the committee is going to find it very easy in discharging its assignment. And therefore, all those members of this committee are advised to take this assignment very seriously, because peace is very important to all of us. Without peace, there's no meaningful development.
Also, during the month under review, Governor Zulum has inaugurated the Governing Council of Ramat Polytechnic under the chairmanship of Barrister Isa Moducho, with 13 other members representing various professional bodies and interest groups. Governor Babagana Zulum directed Secretary to the State Government to outline the Council's mandate to avoid duplication of duties with the Polytechnic's management and charged the Governing Council and management of the institution to work harmoniously and enhance productivity of the institution.
Ramat Polytechnic Maiduguri being one of the most respected tertiary institutions in the state deserve to have a governing council on ground in order not to impede the management of the Polytechnic. And that has necessitated the government of Borno State under my leadership re-establish the governing council. Furthermore, promotions, discipline, among others, are very important items in tertiary institutions. And therefore, re-establishment of this governing council need not to be overemphasized.
That I am the faithful,
bear true allegiance
to the Federal Republic of Nigeria.
Similarly, Professor Babagana Umara has sworn in Haji Azuwe Ragambu as a commissioner and Dr. Helene Haruna Michelia as permanent secretary in the Borno State Civil Service. Also during the month under review, Professor Babagana Umara was in Saudi Arabia and met with Borno pilgrims, thanked them for their prayers and urged them not to relent in praying for peace in Borno and Nigeria, as well as successful conduct of the 2023 general elections. Governor Zulum announced a 300 rial support for each of the Borno pilgrims to enable them purchase sacrificial animals and pray Allah to accept their religious right and safe return home.
So far, so good. I've seen the level of preparation to some certain extent. I'm okay. I think the place of Abu is good. I hope they will improve upon. For the pilgrims, there's nothing I can say rather than to praise them for the prayers that they have been doing to the good people of Borno State as well as our humble servant.
In another development, Governor Umar Azulum chaired the APC stakeholders meeting in Maiduguri to decide on a credible candidate that can fill the Borno Central Senatorial seat vacuum created following the nomination of Senator Kashim Shettima as running mate of the APC presidential candidate. Addressing the gathering, Professor Babagana Umara implored the stakeholders to eschew polarization and work towards the success of the party at the 2023 polls, and called on eligible citizens to obtain their permanent voter cards. Barrister Kakashewu Lawan was unanimously endorsed as the APC candidate for the vacant Borno Central Senatorial seat. Also in the month of July, Governor Zulum announced the release of 110 million to the newly commissioned Maiduguri branch of the Nigerian Police Force Microfinance Bank. He made the announcement at the commissioning of the Police Microfinance Bank, Borno's branch, designed to provide financial services to 8 small and medium enterprises for police families, their affiliates and civilians in the states.
So use this opportunity to convey my deep appreciation to the Nigerian Police Force for the tremendous contributions that they have been rendering, particularly in Borno State, towards restoring peace in Borno State. And therefore, Borno State government is so happy to work with the Nigerian Police Force. The first 50 million naira should be dedicated to the less privileged in the Nigerian Police Force, especially the first 50%, the 25 million naira should be given to the deceased families of the policemen in Borno State. We lost 30 2 years ago. They have their children. And therefore, the 25 million naira, I want the microfinance bank to deposit this money into the police pocket account. Therefore, this 25 million naira has to be saved in this account and strictly has to be paid to children of the deceased policemen and women in order to pay for their school fees. While the remaining 25 million naira should be deposited into your credit services account with a view to supporting the police women. In order to fulfill my electionary campaign, I want to increase it to become 30 million naira. Some of 30 million naira should now be deposited into the credit services account. I know you have the associations. This money should be disbursed to the families of the police men, especially the women, according to their own resolutions, making a sum of 55 million naira. Then additional 55 million naira should be deposited into your own account as our own share in your own bank.
Alia, the Inspector General of Police, Usman Baba Alkali, described Governor Zulum's support to the Nigerian police force as unquantifiable and thanked him for the generosity.
We want to sincerely thank you for taking our trouble, for being kind to us, for being generous to us, for coming to our assistance in terms of providing welfare and working tools. We must sincerely appreciate you.
Similarly, during the month under review, Governor Babagana Umar Zulum was in the presidential villa Abuja in company of the APC vice presidential candidate Senator Kashim Shettima on a thank you visit to President Muhammadu Buhari. President Buhari expressed delight with the choice and his optimism that the APC ticket will emerge victorious in 2023. The APC vice presidential candidate thanked the president for his empathy, support and the role he played leading to his emergence as running mate to the APC presidential candidate. He showered encomiums on the president for having special concern for Borno and Northeast, citing instances of support rendered to the people such as establishment of the Northeast Development Commission (NEDC) and the independent power plant for Maiduguri by the NNPC, among others.
We are the Nigerian dream team that will catapult the country to a higher pedestal. We are the Nigerian dream team that will redefine the meaning and concept of modern governance. We are the Nigerian dream team that will continue from where the president is going to stop and take us further.
Governor Zulum, who was in company of the vice presidential candidate, described the choice of Senator Kashim Shettima as the best for the country and pledged his loyalty and support to the duo and APC.
His integrity and personality are never in doubt. He has one very important character that is not known to many. He's a true Nigerian. He loves Nigeria. And then he has the intention to unite the entire nation. That is one of his character. He doesn't want to discriminate anybody because of his religion or because of his ethnicity. So I think at the end of the exercise, Nigerians will be happy to have somebody like him. Because when he was leaving office, he entrusted the body of Khan to my humble self that I should treat them very well. And I hope he will replicate what he did at the state level, at the federal level.
Also during the month under review, Governor Babagana Umara was in Dembua town to assess the damage caused by flood to the people of the area. During the visit, Professor Zulum supported over 30,000 residents of Dembua, including 436 victims of the recent downpour, with cash assistance to the tune of 172 million naira. Governor Babagana Umara also coordinated the distribution of food and non-food items that includes 50,000 naira cash, a bag of mess grid, clothing materials and a mat to cushion their hardship, and urged the affected persons to desist from building houses on waterways.
We are here to support the victims of the flood disaster and as well provide non-food items and cash support to vulnerable in this community.
While in Dembua, Governor Zulum directed the allocation of tractors to farmers to accelerate farming activities in the area and inspected the integrated mega Islamic school under construction and thanked the engineers to hasten its completion. Similarly, Professor Umar Azulum has expressed delight with the innovation skill of a 25-year-old Laminu Muhammad from Gubbio local government, who fabricated a farming plow machine, manually pushed, for tilling of farmlands to ease farming activities. Impressed with the innovation of the Sangaya student, who has not seen the four walls of a classroom, pledged to shoulder his education and supported him with 5 million naira to inspire him to produce more plows.
The Borno State government has to commend him, and government will do everything possible to ensure that he progresses in what he has been doing. I think we need to invest in this man so that he can provide the services needed to our people.
I will also link him with the Nigerian Institution of Agricultural Engineering.
Still in the month of July, Governor Babagana Umar Azulum had inspected the ongoing construction of the Borno State University Teaching Hospital along Maiduguri Damaturu Road. The Teaching Hospital and Medical College is a prerequisite for full commencement of College of Medical Sciences at the university, which will also address challenges of healthcare services in the state. The site engineer, Engineer Usman Tejani of Mongono Engineering Nigeria Limited, gave an insight to the graphical overview of the project, explaining to the government that the hospital has 400-bed space capacity with a semi-complex system of building, seminar rooms, classrooms, library, offices in all the department and other critical facilities.
Inside the layout showing all the departments, just as I mentioned earlier, the ones in green is ongoing and then the ones in red are yet to be awarded. And this is just a brief description of the project. The capacity of the hospital is a 400-bedded hospital.
The quality of work done in this hospital is very good. I want to commend the contractors and in particular the
The governor expresses satisfaction with the pace and quality of work so far, said. He is optimistic that the project will be completed before the expiration of his first tenure in office, despite the dwindling federal government allocation to the state, and charged the engineers handling the work to maintain standards.
And it is my sincere belief that after completing this project, this will be one of the beautiful, if not most beautiful, teaching hospitals in Nigeria. The existing secondary health facilities that we have here in Maiduguri are overstretched, hence the need to build the university teaching hospital, not only to provide services needed with the ability to enhance the quality of our students that are coming up to study medicine in the state university, but also to provide qualitative and affordable healthcare delivery systems to the people of Borno State.
Professor Zulum also inspected ongoing construction of township roads and a bridge, which is part of the expansion and dualization of roads and drainages within the state capital and Jere local government. Also in the month of July, Governor Babagana Umar Azulum was in Jammaina, Chad Republic, on the invitation of the Multinational Joint Task Force for the Medallion Honor to its soldiers. The annual event honors over 6,000 soldiers with medals for their gallantry in the fight against insurgency around the Lake Chad region. In a remark, Governor Zulum commended the gallant soldiers for their unquantifiable sacrifice in protecting life and property and urged them to sustain the support of the ongoing massive surrender of insurgents while continuing with the military operations against fighters unwilling to embrace peace. Similarly, in the month of July, Governor Babagana Umar Azulum flagged off the resettlement of the last four internally displaced persons camps in Maiduguri to their ancestral homes voluntarily, in a dignified manner and in accordance with the Kampala Convention. He said, the camps are Daluri 1 and 2 IDP camps, located along Kondigabama Road, the Gubio Road IDP camp, and the Muna El Badawi camp situated along Mafa Road, stressing that with the closure of these camps, official IDP camps in Maiduguri are closed. Governor Zulum lauded the Victim Support Fund for supporting the state government with 1.7 billion naira worth of resettlement materials to fast-track the resettlement drive. He said, the Victim Support Fund is the largest donor organization in the post-insurgency resettlement programs in the state, and has contributed more than any government agency in the reconstruction and rehabilitation of many houses and public buildings destroyed by the Boko Haram insurgents.
Because we can no longer keep them in IDP camps. There is growing prostitution in IDP camps. There is growing procreation without care in IDP camps. There is growing drug abuse in IDP camps. Life in the IDP camp is no more sustainable. And therefore, government has decided to close all internally displaced camps within Maiduguri. We have closed a number of them.
The other component of our support, the second component, is to support the rebuilding of the livelihoods of these families. And that includes now giving them cash support. This cash support is to help them go back to the sort of things that they did. So if they were farmers, is to help them go back to the farm. If they were small businessmen and women, is to also help them to go back into these businesses. Now, we have divided, also the government divided them into three components, and we are giving them the support in that component. That means that we have women that are married. Those ones are going to get their own package of 50,000. The women that are now head of families and running their families, also we are giving them 100,000.
Governor Babagana Umar Azulum rounded up his engagement for the month of July by hosting cream of the society across the country that attended the wedding fatia of daughter of the APC vice presidential candidate, Senator Kashim Shettima held at the Shehu of Borno's palace. The wedding fatia was contracted by Imam Ideni of Borno, Imam Mamman Shettima Saleh, with Governor Zulum standing in as guardian of the bride.
Amin. Amin.
Amin. Shortly after the wedding fatia, a reception was held at the multi-purpose hall government house, Maiduguri.
Thank you.